So it is Elton John prog rock. I don't think so, but when I stop to consider his glittering career, I may have been forced to change my opinion. So, enjoying the climax to Glastonbury 2023 on Sunday night, the immortal Elton was bringing to a close his illustrious career in the UK with a quite staggering 2 hours of hits for his adoring fans. I considered his lofty back catalogue to attempt to find the closest thing to a prog rock track he'd ever recorded and came up with this gem for us to have a look at today. The track Funeral for a Friend, Love Lies Bleeding is next, and I'm back afterwards with my thoughts. Let's play the track. We're definitely in a graveyard. Heavy use of synthesizers here, which was unusual for Elton. Little candle in the wind there. Definitely a different feel to this one than many of his other tracks. guitar hero Davy Johnson. Changing tempo and structure now. Bass line going on there. I think that was D. Murray, sadly passed.
Mm-hmm.
to the distance it goes. Okay, how about that then? Elton John on a prog rock channel. The Funeral for a Friend, Love Lies Bleeding is a two-part epic that opens the monumental album Goodbye Yellow Brick Road from 1973 with a sense of grandeur and anticipation. It clocks in at just under 11 minutes and it's embarked on a musical odyssey that took one on a captivating journey through multiple movements, shifting moods and intricate arrangements. It definitely represented an audacious leap into the realms of progressive rock for Elton, a genre that had really largely eluded him up to this point. This significant composition from Elton demonstrated his growth as an artist and an openness to exploring new musical styles. It had a wide-ranging vision, smooth transition and deep emotional impact. That hauntingly beautiful instrumental introduction, Funeral for a Friend, it captivates from the outset. There's a mesmerising blend of orchestral elements, haunting organ sounds and John's emotive piano playing, and it sets a mournful and introspective tone. This particular section sets the stage for the emotional narrative that unfolds in the subsequent part of the track. The band are also able to expand on the overall theme and take it to the next phase as the crescendo builds throughout. So as the baton gets passed seamlessly to Love Lies Bleeding, a thunderous drum fill signalled a shift in dynamics, introducing a more energetic and rock-orientated atmosphere. John's impassioned vocals soar above a tapestry of guitars, driving bass lines and captivating melodies. Lyrically, the song explores the themes of heartbreak, loss and unrequited love, and it's painted with a poignant and vivid imagery. What sets Funeral for a Friend, Love Lies Bleeding apart from other Elton John compositions is its undeniable progressive rock influence. The track's ambitious structure, intricate instrumental interplay and experimental arrangements showcase a departure from his conventional pop sensibilities. From a technical standpoint, Funeral for a Friend and Love Lies Bleeding exemplifies Elton John's virtuosity as both a pianist and a composer. His nimble if podgy fingers glide effortlessly across the keys, deftly navigating intricate melodies and dazzling flourishes. The band's impeccable musicianship further elevates the track with Davy Johnson's fiery guitar work and Nigel Olsen's thunderous drumming adding layers of intensity and power, absolute standouts. The song was a groundbreaking moment in Elton John's career as it revealed his versatility as a musician. Let me know what you think of this track. Could Elton ever be classed as progressive? I'd be interested in your thoughts. If you've enjoyed this, press the like button. Want to hear more, hit the subscribe and the notification bell. Didn't like it? Come another time to see a different reaction. Check out the screen now for a different reaction, as it's one I know you will love as well. As ever, thanks very much for watching this one, and we'll see you next time.